Hello friends, today we are going to start with the fourth module, that is 3D viewing. In third module we have discussed about 2D viewing. Here we are going to discuss about three dimensional viewing. When you compare three dimensional viewing with the two dimensional viewing, three dimensional viewing is little bit complex compared to 2D viewing process, because in 2D viewing we have a two dimension image as well as a two-dimension screen on which the image is going to be displayed. That is why just we need to take the two-dimensional window coordinates, convert them to two-dimensional viewport coordinates, and we are able to display that particular image onto the screen. But it is not same in 3D viewing, because here what image you are going to display, it is in three dimension, and where you are going to display that screen is in 2D dimension. Hence there is a mismatch in dimension. That is why it is more complex compared to 2D viewing. Now this mismatch can be solved with the help of a concept called projection. Now more about this projection we are going to discuss in next classes. Now we will see how this three dimensional viewing works. Now to transfer a 3D object into a 2D object, we require this projection, and this transformation is done by projection transformations. Now we'll see a complete 3D viewing pipeline. Now first of all we need to take out the modeling coordinates, means the coordinates of a model which you want to display, and that is going to be given as an input to your modeling transformation. Now this modeling transformation will convert those modeling coordinates to world coordinates. Then these world coordinates are going to be given as an input to this viewing transformation. Now the task of this viewing transformation is to convert the world coordinates to the view coordinate. Now up to this point the coordinates are in three dimension. Now the next important process, important step comes, that is projection transformation. Here that conversion of three dimension coordinates to the two dimension coordinates occurs. That is done by your projection transformation, which will convert a three dimension view coordinates to the two dimension projection coordinates. Then these projection coordinates are going to be given to this workstation transformation, and it is going to give us the device coordinates where the image has to be displayed. This is how the 3D viewing pipeline works. First of all we have to take out the modeling coordinates from the model which you want to display. Those modeling coordinates are going to be given as an input to this modeling transformation, which will convert a modeling coordinates to world coordinates. Then these world coordinates are given as an input to this viewing transformation. This viewing transformation will convert the world coordinates to the view coordinates. Now up to this point the coordinates are in three dimension. Then the task of this projection transformation is to convert three dimensional view coordinates to the two dimensional viewing coordinates. Then these two dimensional viewing coordinates are given to this workstation transformation, which will give us the device coordinates where the particular image is going to be displayed. This is how the 3D viewing process works. Now next we will see how we can specify an arbitrary 3D view. Now to specify arbitrary 3D view, first of all we need to see which side of the picture we want to see. Now you can see the picture from four different sides. Either you can see it from left, right, behind, top or front. Okay, hence we need to first of all choose which side of the picture you want to see, and this side is going to be called as view plane. View plane is nothing but the film plane in a camera which is positioned and oriented for a particular shot of the screen. Okay, now this is called as view plane. Now next assume that this is a right-handed viewing coordinate system where you have x-axis, z-axis and y-axis of a world coordinates, and this is the coordinate system of a picture to be displayed. Now we need to convert these coordinate systems of a picture to be displayed to this word frame. For that, what are the necessary points we are going to discuss here? First of all, the first viewing parameter we are going to discuss, that is the view reference point. Now this point is the center of our viewing coordinate system. Now the center of your viewing coordinate system is going to be called as your view reference point. And the second parameter is view plane normal vector. Now this normal vector is in the direction perpendicular to the your view plane. This normal vector is the direction perpendicular to the view plane, and it is defined as dxn, dyn, dz. These are the x, y and z points for that particular normal vector. Now with the figure we will see what is this view reference point and view plane normal vector n. Now assume that this is your camera and this is an object which is to be displayed. Now the object is to be displayed is going to be called as view reference point, means from which view you are looking at that object. Now you are looking this object from a right side, hence this will be the view reference. Then this is your view, and the center of this object or the center of this view is going to be called as view reference point, and the line perpendicular from the camera to this object, that is called as view plane normal vector, which is denoted as n, and its coordinates are given as dxn, dyn and dzn. Okay, this is about the basic terminologies used in 3D viewing. Now the view plane normal vector is a directed line, means it is directed from camera to the object. Now the segments from this view plane to the view reference point, which segments the view plane to the view reference point, and this the length between the camera and this object, that is the length of this view plane normal vector, is going to be called as view distance. Okay, the length between the object and the camera is going to be called as view distance, and it tells how far the camera is positioned from the view reference point. Okay, this is about the terminologies of 3D viewing. In next class we will see how to convert the